name is Juan Carlos Holgado, and I'm the FISU Technical Delegate for Archery, and at the same time, I'm the World Archery Event Director. The organizing committee of this World Championship is composed by different groups. We have the local archery group, which is the people who deliver the sport part, what you see, the targets and the tents and all what is the archery part. Then we have a group of people in the organizing committee who is coming from the University of Legnica. So they provide the volunteers and some of the infrastructure and the logistics. And then we have the city support, which is providing budget and is providing some of the equipment like fences or like bands. So it's really a group of three different elements, different groups, and that's what is composed the local organizing committee. And in my position as FISU, what I try is to make them coordinate and to deliver the event in the level that we want.
Hello, welcome in Poland. I am Oskar Roza. I'm from the Polish University Sports Association. I would like to say you something more about our association. We, AZS, Polish University Sports Association, we are working very close together with FISU. All our events are discussed with FISU. We are doing it according to the protocol of the FISU events. We, as the Polish University Sports Association, we have all been organized the World University Championships in Archery. It was the first event this year that we will organize for FISU. The second one will be cycling, just after the archery championships, and then we will have also chess. So it means that we will have for this year three events for the World University Championships. We as Poland, we are very active in this kind of matters. We are in the history of World University Championships. We have already organized more than 20 events, what gives us the second place in the history of World University Championships. I think only France is in front with one event more than we. But I hope that this year we will be equal, or maybe even one more than France.
In an event like this, which is a worldwide event, at the same time it's a world ranking event, which has 32 countries, which have 206 archers and about 70 officials, and controlled by 100 volunteers, or with the support of 100 volunteers, it's not so easy to organize it. This means there have been several months working in meetings and preparation and plans, communication. I had an inspection visit 1 year ago. So it's a work that started a long time ago, and now is the time of delivering the event. And in delivering event, the important thing is communication and coordination. But there is a lot of planning behind and a lot of effort for many people, which we are very proud to be able to coordinate.
Hello, my name is Hunter Jackson, and I'm from the United States of America.
This championship for me means an opportunity to not only represent my country, but also my school, and an opportunity to get to know other archers from around the world that I wouldn't have had the chance to meet before. My personal plans for the future, I'm going for a degree in the College of Veterinary Medicine, hopefully to specialize in small animal surgery or dairy veterinary, and also to continue shooting. Personally, I think Poland is honestly one of the most beautiful countries I've ever been to. The tournament is well ran, everyone here is very friendly and very helpful, the city's gorgeous, and I love shooting here.
I think it's nice to get the opportunity to meet people from the other countries, because shooting in the United States, you're mainly shooting with the same people, and that's still good, but just being able to meet different people and seeing their culture and their style of shooting is also really cool.
My name is Sarah Priels, I'm from Belgium. This is Julien de Poitiers and Baptiste Scarcerio. To me personally, it's a good experience because I used to shoot with the adults, and this is great, the level isn't that hard. So it's a good preparation for next World Cups and the European Championship at the end of the month. The city is really nice, the food is good, the weather is a bit too hot, but yeah, it's great.
Hi, my name is Alexis Madrid. I'm from Mexico and I'm a student from Tetis Universidad. This is my first championship as a student, so this is kind of important to me. So being on my first year here and first final in teams with my teammates means a lot to me, and it's a result for all the effort that we have been putting on this championship. In 3 years, I hope so, I will be graduating from university in child psychology. I want to have my own consultory in, well, do what I love, which is work with kids and help them and their families. And I also see myself in the senior team from archery, and I hope to still do what I like, which is my career and my sport. The three of us have been part of the senior team from Mexico, so we know we have a lot of friends and we met a lot of people from other countries.
We are in Legnica, first of all, because there was a previous organizer, which was Brazil, who asked for this event, and when we're getting close to the time to deliver it, they were not able to deliver. They have some difficulties, and they inform us that they were not able to do this competition. So then we start looking for different options, and one of the options was Legnica. Legnica is a city which has been very supportive with archery, which is a city that welcomes people and wants to have international events. So we approached them with the idea, we told them the difficulties we have, and they were very happy to say, we are here to help, and we would love to have you here. And that's what happened. At the end, we could manage to come, and we really feel welcome, and we can see that what they are doing is the best to make us happy to have made this decision.
Dzień dobry, nazywam się Józef Baściuk, jestem prezydentem 10. Akademickich Mistrzostw Świata w Łucznictwie, Legnica 2014.
Hi, my name is Józef Baściuk, I am the president of the organizing committee of the 10th World University Archery Championship in Legnica 2014. Our city was the world capital of the archery for these 4 or 5 days, and all the participants, officials lived, were here, they were sightseeing, they were going to the restaurants, that's why all Legnica was involved, really involved in this event. The biggest advantage was the fact that hotel, the venue, stadium and city center was in the distance of 1 kilometer. Every sport event has its own requirements, and our every decision was supported by FISU and also confirmed by this organization. Everything was consulted with them, and there were no problems in collaboration.
Now that you mentioned my title as Olympic champion in Barcelona 1992, yes, as an athlete, top athlete I have been, and in my position as World Archery Event Director, I can tell you this, the event is in a high standard. Let's say that we rate the events that we have currently from 0 to 10, this could be a 6 to 7, which is quite high for a university event. The rest to rate the 10 is not a matter of effort, it's a matter of budget. So if we have more budget, we can make the finals instead of the stadium, we can go to the city or the iconic place. But for what they have and the event it's really a high level event, and the archers are seeing that what is the archery part is really in an amazing level.
Hello, my name is Maciej Łaba, I'm the event manager for the World University Archery Championships in Legnica 2014. Organizing such an event which is international, and the number of participants exceeding 200 of participants from 32 countries from over the world is a really hard job to do, because we have to think of many aspects of the event: logistics, accommodation, food, air transportation, and other surrounding events like cultural program, opening ceremony, closing ceremony, medals giving ceremony. Apart from that, the most important thing for the athletes, apart that they have to be brought here to Legnica, put in a hotel and taken care of, is the event venue. As you can see in here, we are in the big, big, beautiful stadium in Legnica, which is new object. We used it for our archery event. We were able to put 34 targets. Thanks to cooperation with World Archery and using their experience, we managed to have a very nice view of the finals, using setting up cameras according to their requirements. It was streamed live on YouTube. It was streamed on the other internet televisions. So thanks to that, many people who are interested in archery could watch us live. The best recommendation for us that we had no complaints from the team. They were satisfied with the field, with the weather, with the results. It was the biggest World Archery University championship so far.
So in my position, I have two hats. I have the World Archery Director, and then I take it out, I have the FISU TV. So it is a good situation to combine the effort and the goals of the two federations. Let's say that we were one of the first federations to join FISU and make an agreement to develop the sport and to make it stronger and better on both sides, in the World Archery side and the FISU side. And the result of it has been that we were a little sport doing some world championship. We grow in the world championship FISU event. And then we asked FISU to be part of the compulsory program in the Summer Universiade. And after several years of being engaged. We finally got married and we are part of this official program. So we are since 2019. So in this good collaboration, we achieved finally that in 2019, in the next Universiade that will be in Taipei, we will have our archery as a compulsory sport. And by then, we don't have World Championship of FISU anymore. It will be just every 2 years, the Summer Universiade, and archery will be present, and we are very proud of this. We are in the environment of university, and this, the age of this time is people want to know each other, and people want to have this instead of social areas of Facebook and Twitter, they want to meet each other. And we have a unique opportunity here in Legnica. We have achieved, and the organizer has proposed that all the athletes, all the teams are in the same hotel. And this is something quite unique. In our events, normally they split the teams in 3 or 4 hotels. This is not the case here. And this has given the possibility to teams to meet during dinner, to be all together having coffee or chatting at night or in the lobby. So that's created a good atmosphere that is quite interesting to see how different countries can have questions and have a social life out of the competition. But then the next day they come here and you see people having coffee, the Mexican with the Malaysian and with the US, and they come here and they compete against each other. And it's quite interesting to see that when they are in competition shooting line, they are quite competitors and you don't see them so united, but as soon as they finish the competition, they go behind the shooting line in the waiting area, they become again a family. So it's quite interesting to see this and bring very good memories in my time of when I was a top archer, when we have this kind of family, that the sport was not so professional and was easy to have a friendship with other teams. And give me a nice memory of this atmosphere of family.
Hello, my name is Toja Černe. I'm coming from Slovenia and I'm shooting for University of Ljubljana. It's another great experience for me. Actually, I can see that my work is good, so I will continue with shooting and like this work. And I'm honored to present my country and the University of Ljubljana. I'm studying sport, so yeah, I will continue for at least 10 years and then we will see what life brings. Actually, I'm here for third time now. And yes, I like it. I think people are kind and, well, the championship was okay. So yes, I like it. I have a lot of friends in archery because I'm competing in other competitions all over the world as well. So yes, I have a lot of friends.
Hi, I'm Mauro Nespoli from Italy. This championship for me is very important because I'm restart shooting after the Olympic Games in Beijing when we won the silver medal with the team, and I had some problem with the competition after this medal because we were very near, very close to the gold medal, and one arrow I shot made us the silver medal and not the gold. So I had some problem, and with this competition I had the possibility in 2010 to restart, to come back in this level competition. After that I won the gold medal with the team in London. My personal plans for the future are continuing sport. I'm an archer, I like it, I'm studying sport. Now I'm shooting, maybe I'll shoot to Rio and why not Tokyo 2020. I like Poland, I like this city, I like people, I like everything here, this fantastic field, a lot of church, why not? Many bars, many pubs were fine and meet a lot of nice and very friendly person, people. I know many archers before this competition, and I meet new friends in this occasion. So maybe from Korea, USA, Great Britain, Netherlands, we are many. So it's nice when we are in the same place because we can talk, we can meet, we can talk about this sport, about our study, and it's very nice.
Hi, my name is Hanna Majerova and I'm from Czech Republic. I have to say it was a very nice competition. Tournament was organized very well. There was no problem. We were satisfied with everything. Well, Poland is next to Czech Republic, so it's very close and it's kind of similar country. So we feel like at home. It's easy to us to talk to Poland, Polish people. And everybody was very nice and friendly and helping, so it was very nice. I think so many archers, they know each other from other competitions. And also in my team, they were competing as a junior, so they know a few people and they are getting to know a new one. And archery is quite family sport. Everybody knows everybody and it's very nice. Everybody's friendly.
We are very close to finish the championship and we are already thinking the next one. And the next one will be Mongolia, in the capital of a country which is very famous for archery, for the traditional archery. So we are very glad to go to Asia. We are very glad to be in Mongolia. That will be the last University World Championship because as being part of the University at Fixed Program, there's no more World Championship anymore. But we already start working for this championship with the delegation that is here. We had already some meetings. And from now on, we will start working to deliver the best University World Championship in Mongolia in 2016.
My name is Jargal Sekha. I'm Secretary General Mongolian University Sports Federation of Mongolia. Championship was very good and the record number of participation country, record number of delegation and technical side is very good. And we invited 2016 next championship from Legnica, some specialists to the and cooperation with the Mongolian National University Sports Federation. Mongolia, a member of FISU, start 1977. Mongolian first athletes participating Universal Games 1965. In Mongolia and very and long time history cooperation with FISU. Every Universal Games participating Mongolian student. Also this, especially this year, we participating 10 World University Championship. Also we organized and World University Championship 3 times. 2002 chess, 2006 wrestling, 2010 boxing. Our next championship 2016 and archery.
And see you in Mongolia.